Hello all, in today's session we are going to discuss about the folded dipole antenna. Now let us see what is the definition of the folded dipole antenna first. So it consists of a two parallel wire, or you can say two parallel dipole connected at the end forming a narrow wire loop. Now let us see the construction of this particular dipole antenna. Suppose these are nothing but the feed points, or these are the transmission line, these are nothing but the feed points. Here you are having a normal dipole, these are the two dipoles as you are having. So I can say this is the transmission line, these are nothing but the feed points, and now here I have connected another dipoles over here, so separated by a distance d, and this is nothing but another dipole, which, or I can say another conductor which I have connected over here, which is separated by the distance d. The length of this will be the l. Okay, so as shown in this figure, the length of the folded dipole is l and the separation between the dipoles is d. Now you can see this d is a much smaller than l and the wavelength lambda. So this is nothing but the construction of the folded dipole. Now it has a two very important properties. Now let us see what are that two important properties are there. So the first property is nothing but the, so if I write the properties over here, so I can say the first property of this folded dipole, it is having a very high impedance. If you compare this impedance with the folded, or if you compare this impedance with the half wave dipole, this will be the very high impedance. And the second property is nothing but the, it increases the bandwidth. Which is very essential in the FM and the TV application. So these are very important properties of the folded dipole antenna. Now when the length L is equal to lambda by 2 structure, if this particular length I'm considering is equal to lambda by 2, this particular folded dipole structure will be called as the half wave folded dipole antenna. So we can say if length is lambda by 2, this will be called as a half wave folded dipole. Now we'll discuss about the input impedance of this particular folded dipole antenna. So as we know that half wave dipole antenna is having an input impedance of 73 ohm. Now we'll let us discuss what will be the input impedance of folded dipole. So let us talk about the half wave dipole whose Z in is near about 73 plus j 42.5 ohm. so this is the input impedance of half wave dipole. Now this dipole can be connected effectively to the 75 ohm coaxial cable. So 75 ohm coaxial cable connected effectively. But if I consider the TV application, here for the TV application we are using a twin lead transmission line. So if I consider this is a twin lead transmission line, this twin lead transmission line will have a 300 ohm impedance. So with this particular structure you can't connect, not possible for half wave dipole to match 300 ohm. Now there we require antenna having an input impedance greater than a half wave dipole. So this is possible by using the folded. So using folded dipole, these things are possible. Now here the operation of the folded dipole, if we consider the operation of the folded dipole antenna, your folded dipole antenna can be analyzed by considering two modes. So here folded dipole antenna will have two modes. So the first mode here is nothing but the transmission line mode. and the second mode will be nothing but the antenna mode. Now let us discuss each and every mode about this particular antenna one by one. So we'll talk first about the transmission line mode. What happens in this particular mode? So I'll talk about the transmission line mode. Now here I'll draw a one figure over here so you'll understand what kind of things will be there. So this is nothing but our transmission lines, these are the feed points, and here you can consider this is nothing but the folded dipole kind of the structure. So here now I can say these are the current in the two arms. Now here if I give see the current distribution here and here opposite, okay, here and here I can see these are nothing but the they form a loop A and B, or the distribution is from A to B. So I can say this is IT, this is the closed circuit, or you can see here the current distribution or the distribution of the current. Yaha pe, this one is the currents. So currents in two arms in opposite direction. Okay, now let us discuss what this mode is all about. So in the transmission line mode, we consider antenna to be a part of a transmission line. So here what we are considering, this antenna is a part of transmission line. So you can see here, if it is the part of the transmission line, we are closing the far ends of the line at the point A and B as shown in the figure. So this transmission line current is denoted by IT. ठीक है. Now this is first mode. Now the second mode is nothing but the, we are using it in the antenna mode. So the antenna mode here, if you see in the antenna mode, what happens with this particular folded dipole antenna? I'll draw the same kind of things over here, as we know that this is nothing but the first mode, it's a transmission line mode. We are having this kind of the structure in the folded dipole antenna. ठीक है. So here you can see the current directions are in the same, so you can say this will be the induced current IA by 2, and again this will be the IA by 2. And this you can denote with the currents in two arms in same direction. So in the antenna mode, we consider here what we consider, we consider that the current in the second arm, so current in the second arm which is not connected to the transmission line. So it is not connected, but it is the induced current. So here we are considering that our current is not connected to the transmission line, so it is the induced current. So I can say it is the induced current due to current in the arm connected to the transmission line. ठीक है. So this is the current which is denoted by IA. Now it is, you can see this current is nothing but the induced current and it is not the transmitted current. So as far as radiation is concerned, it is only due to the antenna current. So here what we can say, the radiations are due to antenna current. So in the transmission mode, current in two arms are in opposite direction, cancelling each other, as we have already seen how our dipole works. So in the transmission line, they will cancel each other, but in the antenna mode, the currents in two arms in the same direction, increasing the radiations. Now let us talk about the input impedance in the transmission line mode. ठीक है. So first we'll talk about the input impedance in transmission line mode. Now in the transmission line theory, the standard formula is available for the short circuited transmission line length L. So Z in is equal to J Z0 tan of beta L, whereas transmission line length is nothing but the L. So Z0 is the characteristic impedance of transmission line. L is nothing but the length of the transmission line. Okay. So the folded dipole shown here in the transmission line method, as we have already gone through this one, the length L is elongated, it will become a short circuited transmission line of length L by 2. So the input impedance of the folded dipole in the transmission line will be denoted by ZT. So I can say ZT in transmission line mode, your L is equal to L by 2, and you can say your ZT is equal to input impedance. Now let us see how we can go for this particular thing. So here ZT is equal to J Z0 tan of beta L by 2. Theek hai? Now here when we are talking about the input impedance of the transmission line mode, here we can write this is nothing but the your transmission line mode. Here you can see this is your folded dipole. Theek hai? Feed lines, this is the feed point, you can say. You are having this Z0, characteristic impedance of the transmission line. This is A and B, and this is nothing but the length L, complete length L. That's why we have considered it as A by 2. If I simplify this particular transmission line or this particular folded dipole antenna, this will be A, this will be B. Theek hai? This is the folded dipole, you can say. This is a folded dipole elongated. I can say this is the length L by 2, and this is nothing but the Z, that is input impedance. Theek hai? Now suppose a voltage V is applied across the terminal. So here I am assuming that is the voltage which I am applying is nothing but the V is nothing but the voltage applied to input terminals. So the total behavior is obtained by using the superposition of the equivalent circuits. So here we'll talk about both the modes. The first one is nothing but the transmission mode. So whereas I can see here in the transmission mode, you will have this voltage, this kind of the voltage here, and these are nothing but the folded dipole. So this will be the V by 2, and this will be the V by 2. This will be plus minus, and this will be minus plus. So I can say this will be the IT, and this will be in the opposite direction IT. So this will be the A. So this will be your transmission line mode. And if I talk about the same thing about, you can say, your antenna mode, I will have this kind of the structure over there. So here I'll have V by 2. Here also it will be V by 2. Now but the directions will be same. So this will be IA by 2, and this will be IA by 2. So I can say this is the figure number B. This mode is nothing but the transmission line mode, and this will be nothing but the antenna mode. Theek hai? So we'll obtain the total behavior here with the superposition of the equivalent circuit. So these are the equivalent circuits. Now note that the figure A and B are superimposed, then the total voltage on the left element is V, while on the right element is the zero, because they'll cancel each other. The transmission line current is now obtained as, okay, now here note that you are having a figure A and a figure B. Now these are superimposed, then the total voltage on the left element is V, while on the right element is zero. The transmission line current is now obtained as, now how we are going to obtain the transmission line current? So IT is equal to V by 2, ZT is equal to V divided by to ZT. Now where ZT is obtained by using the previous equation which we have seen. So here for the antenna mode, now this is all about the I of T for the transmission line mode. Now let us talk about the antenna mode. As we can see here, this is nothing but the antenna mode. So I'll talk about the antenna mode now. So I can write here, for antenna mode, the total current is the sum of the current of each arm. So you can say the IA is equal to V by 2 divided by ZT, which is nothing but the V by 2 ZT. So ZT here is nothing but the impedance of ordinary dipole. So this is all about the IA for the antenna mode. So let us discuss further the total voltage on the left element V obtained by superposition of the voltages in both the figures. The total current I total is equal to IT plus IA by 2. So the input impedance of the folded dipole here is, if I am talking about the input impedance, so input impedance of the folded dipole Zin is equal to V I total, which is V, divided by IT plus IA by 2. So using IT and IA from equations which we have already seen, IA we have seen here, so Zin is equal to V divided by V by 2 ZT plus V by 4 ZT. ठीक है, so while solving all these things I'll get here is equal to, I can say it will be 4 ZT Z0 divided by ZT plus 2 ZT. So this is nothing but, now consider the length of the folded dipole here is L is equal to lambda by 2. So we'll calculate this for lambda by 2. So consider L is equal to lambda by 2. Now using the previous equations, I can write ZT is equal to Z0 tan beta L by 2. Now which is nothing but the J Z0 tan of, we know this is the phase constant, 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 4 is equal to J Z0 tan of pi by 2, which is nothing but the infinity. ठीक है, so ZT is infinite. Now putting this value in the previous equation, we can get here. So putting this value, you can write Zin is equal to 4 ZT ZT divided by ZT plus 2 ZT, which is nothing but the 4 ZT divided by 1 plus 2 ZT ZT, which comes 4 ZT. Now this is nothing but the which we have got by solving all these things. Now this equation says that input impedance of the folded dipole at a resonance is 4 times greater than of the isolated dipole of the same length. So you can say this, if you are talking, I can say this ZT is nothing but the dipole impedance, whereas I can conclude that my input impedance of this particular will be 4 times larger than. So as we know that our input impedance for the, we can say the normal dipole is 73 ohm at the resonance, and that's why we can say Zin is equal to 4 ZD, which is nothing but 292 ohm. So Zin for this particular, you can say, folded dipole antenna is 292 ohm. So as we know that this is nothing but our requirement for the TV application, that your input impedance must be 300 ohm or close to 300 ohm. You are having it close to the 300 ohm, so it can be used for the TV application where we are using a twin lead wires. So this is all about the folded dipole antenna. Thank you.